Hey, this is Matsan and welcome to our culture section.
Culture section. Today we're going to talk about
things that Poland has and Taiwan doesn't have.
Part 2. So let's get into it.
Our registration plates in Poland. We do have the numbers and the letters. And firstly, we have the letters.
The codes in the beginning. English codes.
And this English code, these letters can be like 2 letters or 3 letters. Everything depends on the city and on the voivodeship region you are.
Yes.
Your car was registered.
Yeah, so for example, take your car as example. So you're from Lublin.
Yes.
So the code in the beginning will be LU.
LU.
And then following by random numbers. From the car plate, you can see which city this person came from, right?
Yeah.
That's quite interesting. And also, it's our interest, like when we're driving on the road and I'm like, oh, there's a car from Gdańsk. Oh, there's a car from Krakow. Like, it's pretty fun. It's quite interesting on the street in Poland to see that. And in
pretty
Taiwan,
colorful.
In Taiwan we don't. The numbers are usually random. Yeah.
We use indicators and the flash of our lights on the road to inform about something in Poland. So for example, when you are passing the car and the car lets you pass them, like give you some space to pass them easily,
you
will usually thank them. And by thanking, we say basically this
indicator
sign, which is this broken car indicator.
The triangle sign. Yeah.
So you just press it, so it's gonna shine for a while and then press it again.
So it means thank you, that's it.
It means thank you, yes.
Can you admit sorry, like if you do something stupid and you do this as well?
People sometimes do that as well. So it's thank you or sorry on the road. Also, you can use the flash of your lights.
Yeah.
For example, for informing people that they didn't turn their lights on. Or you can also do the same if you want to inform about the police. Like, the person who is
facing you,
the car facing you, they saw the police is there, so they will use the flash as well to inform you, there is the police near you, so just slow down.
It was fun in the beginning for me that he told me that you can press this indicator to say thank you. I'm like, whoa, I'm gonna do it. We use horn to say thank you, like, papa. But you don't?
No. We do this only like the accident is going on or some retard.
Like, that. So we sometimes use that to say thank you. Reminds me of this GTA 5. This.
In Poland, we've got a law that you cannot sell the alcohol to drunk people. Not every shop cares
about
this. You can see that regularly that actually people sell the alcohol to drunken. But in Taiwan, there is even not a law like this, right?
So far as I know, there's no law like this. But I think it's because
people are not drinking that much in Taiwan.
Yes, drinking is not a problem in Taiwan. So they don't really have this kind of law strictly being set. But I read some news because it is like drink and drive. It is a problem. Yeah, so because of these accidents, people are trying to raise this topic. Maybe we should set this law like European country, like America.
Yeah,
but I don't hear so much voice about this. And the next thing, Poland got Names Day, but Taiwan doesn't have it. Names Day is different than birthday in Poland, right? So you can have 2 birthdays, basically.
I would say younger generation doesn't do that at all right now. We have Names Day. For example, I don't even know where is my Names Day. And every time my grandma's calling me, she calls me and happy Names Day and so on. I'm like super surprised because I don't even know that I've got Names Day at that day.
But how does it work about this Names Day?
You've got a calendar with the names there and just your names means, like, for example, it's gonna be, I don't know, 16th of June. And it means that at 16th of June you've got your name and your name's day. Right?
So is there lots of names in one day?
Sometimes there are like 2 names even, sometimes, I don't know, maybe 3. Poland doesn't really do that right now. It's mostly about the older generations. Because they treat it as a birthday. They don't really they are not focused on birthday, mm-hmm. they are focused on Namesday
names
more.
Namesday.
And we are already like a birthday people, so mm-hmm. we rather spend time with our friends and so on birthday uh-huh. and have gifts.
And also I think because in Poland the name is more like generally pretty much the same, like guys are Jacek, Mateusz, like those few names. Mm-hmm. So it's easier for people to categorize these names because huh? in our
yes,
case everybody
yes.
got like super different name. You
also,
can be super creative. Mm-hmm. So.
Train stations, bus stations, everything like that, you have to pay for the toilet.
Mm-hmm.
Mm, it's pretty bad because sometimes you even pay like 3 złoty
yeah.
for one peeing.
Yes.
And it's a lot, right?
Yes, it's a
so
lot.
So just imagine Poland is pretty big comparing to Taiwan. Mm-hmm. And if you want to travel by bus to another city, which will take you, for example,
four
you
know,
6 hours or 4 hours,
yeah.
and there are stops in every station.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to pee,
yeah.
you have to pay for every toilet. So
also, it's quite inconvenient because of this long time travel.
Mm-hmm.
So you feel like you're so nervous because in the bus there's no toilet. So before
some
you
buses don't.
Yeah,
buses,
I mean lots of them they don't.
Yeah.
Yeah. So in this case, before you travel, you need to pee. So mm-hmm. you pay.
It's like of course you need to pee.
Yeah. And in the bus you're like I don't want to drink water that much because mm-hmm. I don't know when will be the next.
Yeah. You are not that relaxed at driving.
Yeah.
Going by bus, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So in this case, train wins. I don't like trains, but train wins because train at least has got a toilet there and you don't have to pay for that toilet. But it's disgusting. It smells, stinks.
Yeah, I had an experience in the train that I went to the toilet and the lock is kind of broken because that train we took is pretty old. Yeah, so I'm like, okay, it's locked. And I'm peeing and after pee I'm wearing my pants. And before I wore my panty, a guy just opened the door like, he really see my there.
You're there. And
yeah.
he got horny.
No, and he's like, oh, shubrusha, like, sorry. And I was like, this is so awkward. The conclusion about this, not to pay before travel, you can go to shopping mall next to the train station, bus station.
Uh-huh, yeah. She was even surprised that she can actually get into that place even if she doesn't have any permission to vote. And
yeah.
what she saw, there are like only like just some covers, not that much, like mm. people are not so strict about that.
Yes, because in Taiwan we also do the voting in school, usually in the classroom,
mm-hmm.
but they set up like a booth, you know, like with a cover.
Some
like
kind this, of chamber?
No, it looks like this photo booth.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, looks like that. So there are like 4 of them and you get the votes, like this paper
mm-hmm.
from those people, administrators, and then you get into this booth. It's like very secretly voting mm-hmm. and you cannot show your vote to anyone else.
And also they've got the stamps. We've got X.
Yeah,
you have to just cross
mm-hmm,
the
so
person you want and you just got stamps.
We got stamps, yeah, because people say that if you write their name, it will be somehow leaking the idea that who you are voting for.
Mm-hmm.
So the main idea is to not show who you vote for. So you cannot show your ticket to the public
uh-huh.
or make a selfie and upload on Facebook. It's definitely illegal. In Taiwan, when you go to convenience store like 7-Eleven or Żabka, this kind of store, and you don't say like, hello. Hi, good morning to those cashiers.
So you just start the conversation by, I would like to buy this one.
Yeah, or just, hi. Like,
hi.
It doesn't really matter if you say greeting to them or not.
Mm-hmm.
But in Poland, people are very polite, even to strangers. So whenever you start a conversation with a cashier and so on, you say, dzień dobry, and then you start to say what you want.
Mm-hmm. And do widzenia.
Yeah, and when you finish your buying, shopping, you say do widzenia. Yeah, thank you, goodbye.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's super, super polite for me. We don't really do that. And about smacznego, like bon appetit, it's more like when I'm working in the office. Even though those colleagues, they don't know you, they still say smacznego, wish you have a great appetite. When they say smacznego, you have to say thank you, dzięki. Koniec!
Poland, when you are driving, you've got the signs
mm-hmm.
which are informing you that there might be animal crossing from this forest to that forest or something. So you see the picture of the animal.
You can see cow and sheep when you're driving in the countryside
mm-hmm.
across the city in Poland. I'm always so amazed by those cows. They're so cute! Mm-hmm. At one point.
So that's pretty much it, and hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you guys learned something more about differences of Poland and Taiwan.
Yes! Well, please still like this video, subscribe to the channel.
Comments below. Don't forget about Facebook fans page. Yeah, we love you as always, Taijian, and stay juicy.